second session, morning session of the conference on democracy and secular sectarianism. We are looking at three papers. I'll make a few introductory remarks, keep them brief, and then leave it to the paper presenters to make their arguments. There are just a couple of things that I wanted to highlight here. One is, I would have really wanted, and I would like for the rest of the proceedings during the day, for us to think a little more about the kind of problem that this conference and Professor Gudavarti is trying to frame, in some sense, with the idea of sectarianism here. If it becomes possible to think a little more closely about what we understand by sectarianism, what are we actually trying to criticize here? You know, are we trying to think about a certain tendency of dogmatism, complete lack of regard for others and other kinds of politics, so on and so forth, to flesh out the idea of sectarianism, and you know, how are we looking at critiquing that question? Because there is certainly a sense of a larger impasse, crisis, puzzlement, so on and so forth, that we are looking at in terms of addressing the issue of progressive politics, of democratic politics. And it is important to think deeply about what is the nature of crisis. What is that nature of crisis? We have heard reflections on this question throughout the day, yesterday, and in the panel that just happened, focused the question particularly on the left. And let me take a cue from that discussion, an excellent morning panel to my mind, and just flag the issue that is at stake, which is, are we really looking at a crisis of describing, theorizing, or understanding politics in terms of left-right polarization? And there have been suggestions from paper presenters yesterday, Adrian, and even today from presenters, that this is what really is the problem in some sense, and instead of this left-right polarization, we may need to rethink the terms of democratic and progressive politics in some sense. Now, this is an important issue to consider, and looking at questions of identity politics, looking at a certain transformation in society, which has, for instance, you know, managed to flag the social and cultural questions in some sense over the primacy of economic questions in some sense with regard to political agenda, that becomes interesting to think about, because that is what I suppose poses a certain crisis to a certain language of doing politics that we were familiar with even, let's say, a decade back or so. Now, how do we think about this question? And to my mind, the crisis that we are, it is important to identify the nature of this crisis. And to my mind, this crisis is something that can be apprehended to begin with by the question of something like sectarianism, but perhaps it is also larger. It has other kind of critical dimensions to it. Today morning, I just kind of read a small piece of news in the editorial of the newspaper Indian Express, which has flashed a very, very interesting piece of information, which is that the new inclusion in the Oxford English Dictionary is a new term called post-truth. You know? And it's a very telling kind of an inclusion, because the understanding behind this inclusion is that there is a way in which Brexit and the politics that has followed thereafter is beginning to show that politics is no longer being primarily conducted by what could be taken as serious and scientific truth claims. There are very serious appeals that are gaining ground, that are being successful, which are based on pure mendacity, which are based on lies, which are based on hypocrisy, so on and so forth. But how to understand, you know, what is at work in these kind of developments is a serious question. Now the trouble to my mind is, and I would just make this small point and leave it to the paper givers, is that there is a certain crisis that I believe in the language in which traditional left politics has been conducted. At the same time, the question of left politics and right politics refuse to go away when we consider the question of capitalism and neoliberalism. All the older categories of class politics and questions of class struggle, you know, seem to come back, you know, no less importantly as they were before, along with the new kind of social and cultural questions of politics. So that relevance does not go away. Is it then, in some sense, not a crisis of the understanding of the critical discourse and critique of capitalism offered by Marxism, but a crisis in the language in which that politics has been conducted? And this is one possibility that I would like you to consider, that there may be, this might be a time to rethink, firstly, the language in which left politics, progressive politics and Marxist politics is conducted. And one of the points that I want to flag here, with regard to this question of rethinking the language of progressive and left politics, is really the question of who is the subject of politics today. We know that the manner in which traditional progressive or left politics frames this question is basically in terms of class, in terms of the working class and peasantry, in terms of a certain imagination of who constitutes the subject, in some sense, of radical politics, transformative politics. And this, at the same time, we know, has become a category which refuses to allow other kinds of subject formations, other kinds of political subjects and entry. Now, this, how to kind of have a conversation, how to have a kind of dialogue, a meaningful dialogue, a dialogue that could lead towards alliances and alignments with other kinds of political subjects, which cannot be entirely contained, subsumed, and subordinated to the question of class, is, I think, the one of the serious and important questions today. Whether we are thinking of feminist politics, whether we think of identity politics, so on and so forth. How to think about these other kind of subjects is really, to my mind, the big challenge before progressive and Marxist politics today. How to address this question. And there is a way here whereby Marxism is beginning to negotiate this question through the question of democracy. By framing this issue in terms of the idea of demos, when we look at philosophers like Jacques Rancière, the idea of the people or the idea of the multitude in Hart and Negri, so on and so forth. That here is a certain kind of epistemological transition, in some sense, from an older idea of a politics based primarily and exclusively on working class and peasantry sorts of questions, to imagining a new kind of transformative politics that will be able to address these other kinds of political subjects who are no less crucial, critical members of the political public that we call the people of a country, in some sense. And who are these people? Now, this is where I would leave the cue to my presenters, because the three papers that are scheduled for this session, Nathalie Reynolds, Shagato Sarkar, and Morshid Alam, are all going to speak about these other kind of political subjects in some sense. So, over to them, and I would like to come back towards the end with a few remarks on the paper. So,